So we'll start with an option 3D extrude. Okay, so we'll see what is 3D extrude. We can create 3D objects, okay, inside this Illustrator. So I'm going to create one star, and I will be applying one color to this. I will remove the outline, then I will apply effect, okay, and here see, this is the latest version, okay, this is the latest version. And what you have to do is, see here two options are there. See, extrude and bevel, and in the top extrude and bevel option is there, and here also extrude 3D classic extrude and bevel is there. So in case you are using latest version, don't try to select this one. See, don't try to select this extrude and bevel, try to select this one, okay. But I think I think you are using older versions, I think.
Latest.
Okay, latest 22 only. Okay, then you try to select this, okay. Okay, see here, automatically, see, you can see the extrude.
Sir, if at all it is old version.
If it is old version, you have to directly, you will not see any of these options. You will directly see only these three options. Okay.
Okay.
In old version. Okay. So here you can see some options here. See. Automatically when I applied this extrude, so you can see a depth. There is some depth here. Okay. What I will do is, I will first keep 0 here in these input fields. See. Okay. And then what I can do is, see, let me actually rotate it like this, okay. See, right now you cannot see any extrusion. So what I will do is, see, I will try to put my cursor in the second axis, y axis, and then I will hit up arrow. So you can see, okay, if I hit down arrow, it will rotate in this way. See, now you can see. So we can see all the sides. Okay, like this. Let me keep it 0. Okay, and let me try to, just a minute. Let me try to apply this extrusion again. Okay, let me keep 0 in all these input fields. And let us try to put our cursor in the top axis, okay, this is x axis, and just hit up arrow. You know, you can see the depth. I can keep it flat like this, okay. And then here actually it is 70 degrees, and here you can see the extrusion depth, and put your cursor there, and then you can hit the down arrow here. See, yeah. This is the extrusion depth. So how much depth you want? Okay. Then see here. Here we have extra options like bevel. See, if I click on this bevel, so you can see the change. Classic bevel, you can see some extra attraction to this. There are different types of bevels you can select. See, but what we'll do is, we'll just remove the bevel. So we only want this much here. So we'll just click OK now. Okay, we got a 3D star. Okay, now what we'll do is, see, we'll apply our own colors to this. So we can apply our own colors simply. We have to first expand this. This is very important. In order to apply colors, we have to expand. Object expand. okay? When you say object expand, what will happen? See, it will become a normal object, but to apply colors, we have to ungroup this. So how to ungroup? Right click, ungroup. See. Now it has become different pieces. So it is now ungrouped. So I can give some different colors to this. So it is broken into different pieces, and then I can give different colors to the top part and also to the extruded part. Like this. To make it more interesting, we can apply swatches to this. I think I told you about swatches. Okay, let me apply swatches to this. So what are swatches? Swatches are like ready made gradients. Okay, we just open swatches, and here we can see the swatches libraries. And in swatches libraries, we have many ready made gradients. Here just open the gradient, go to gradient, and let us select these gems and jewels. And let me open some color to this. See. And for the back part, let me apply a red color. Okay, see here, we'll apply this. See, we can see. And to make it more interesting, see, I can actually apply one outline. We'll try to give it a yellow outline. Okay, see. Okay, we can select all these objects. We can also apply the same yellow outline to this, but we will try to reduce the size of the yellow outline. See here. So we have a star which has depth. Okay, right. So the next thing we'll do is, we will try to apply the extrusion to letters. So if you export it in SVG, it will be like an outside file. Means that file you cannot do editing. You want to edit the file, you have to save it in AI format. That is Illustrator format. Means directly you have to file save as. Like this you have to do. You have to use the AI format. If you save in AI format, you can edit that file. You can directly open the file again in Illustrator and do the editing.
Not like that. Hmm.
3D object means what? What you are saying? You want to animate? Animation is not there in Illustrator. In 3D softwares you are saying, can you export the 3D objects from Illustrator to other 3D softwares? No, it's not possible, because in 3D softwares like 3ds Max, Maya, their options are different.
Not in After Effects.
In After Effects also, you can export it as a normal object. Means it like an image you can import. It's not like what some kind of 3ds Max, or it's not like a Maya file or 3ds Max file. Okay.
Hello.
Sir,
now you have done that ungrouping. Now grouping is not required.
Ungroup, I have done ungrouping because I want to apply separate colors to each part, and then after that, applying colors again, if you want to control the complete object, you have to group it. Okay, so I will do the same thing again with a letter this time. I am going to take a letter, so we will use a letter A. Okay. So we'll give it a font. Okay, we'll give it a font let us say okay, we'll give impact. Okay. So then what I will do is here, I will actually first create an outlines for this letter A. Instead of directly applying extrude options, we can directly apply extrude option to this. See, for example, see here yellow, I have applied yellow color, and if I go to extrude and select this option, see I have directly applied this. So this is same like that star, okay. But what we will do is, instead of applying it like this, so let me actually select an outline, turn off the fill, okay. Then I will select this pen tool, then let me create a cut, okay, like this, okay. And then hit enter. Okay, so I have created like this, but the thing is, we have to also make this outline as a normal object. So for that, again we have to expand the outline like this. Then what is the next thing we'll do? We'll apply colors by using shape builder. Okay, so we'll just select the entire shape, and we'll select the shape builder, we'll pick one color here, okay, and then we'll apply blue color here. Okay, then I will delete this extra shapes, this one also, okay. Then what we'll do is, we will actually turn off the stroke. See, then I will actually just move it by using the this one, direct selection. You can move it, keep it like this, okay. Then what we'll do is, select everything, and then we will apply extrude here, okay. We'll group it, actually group it, and then we'll just go to effect and we'll apply extrude.
Sir, control G.
Yeah,
grouping.
Grouping is control G, so we'll keep it zero here. Okay, and then we'll put our cursor in this y axis, and then we'll just use the down arrow. See here. So you want this inside part to show up. Okay. Something like this. Okay, just click OK. See, so the next thing we'll do is, see, we'll expand it, okay. So then what we'll do, we'll ungroup it, keep ungrouping, okay, till you see all the objects outside like this, okay. Now what I'll do is, see, I will apply this gradient colors from swatches. So just open the swatches. See here. Here we'll go to this libraries. Okay, and from here we'll select the gradient, and see, we'll select this gems and jewels only. Okay. Then we'll apply a blue color and green color like this, okay. See, then for the back parts, We'll apply this red color. So see here, this part actually, what you have to do is we have to unite this part, okay? Because if not, it's not coming properly. See, so what you have to do, just simply open the path finder and unite. So see here. See. Okay, so like this, see, we have applied colors. Now what we'll do is, to make it more interesting, see, I will create outlines, okay, custom outlines, not the outlines from this one. Here we can create stroke, but instead we'll create our own outlines. So how I will create, see. So I am going to select this pen tool, okay, and then what I will do is, see, let me keep only stroke here. Let us turn off the fill and we will create a yellow color stroke, okay, and just we have to create outlines over these borders, and our path should exactly run along this path, okay, run along these borders. So if you want to make it run along these borders, so we have to actually turn on one more option, that is, okay, snap to point. Check whether this is on or not. Okay, snap to point should be on. So now we'll just click here. See here, see. Okay, just we'll do it like this and then hit enter, zoom it, use a direct selection tool, okay, say something like this. Okay, and I will do the same thing. See, actually I will change the shape here, shape of the outline. See, the outline is looking having same width, okay, same width from the starting point to ending point. So I am going to change the look of this. See here, here we have some options, so I will change it to this one. So you can see how it has changed. See, it is sharp at the starting and then it is thick in the middle. Able to understand? See, I will show you. I will try to increase the size. See here. See, now you can see the look of this. Okay, but we don't want this much thickness. So we'll reduce the thickness. Okay. I'll make it even thinner. Okay, we'll do the same thing in this place. Select the pen tool again. Okay, enter. Just adjust it. So again, what you do, select it and then, so just keep it here, okay. Okay. And then last and final, We'll do the same thing over here. Okay. Right. So something attractive. So then we will make it more interesting. See, I'll select the outline and we'll expand it. Okay. Expand. We'll expand all these outlines. Okay. Expand. Okay. So after expanding, so what we'll do is we'll apply gradient colors to this. Okay. So what I will do is, see, I will go to one more option here in swatches, gradients, and we'll select metals. We'll apply metallic gradients here. See, we can apply this first one, golden metal. See, for all these objects we'll apply a golden metal. Okay, see, we got a golden metallic look. Okay, understood? So now it looks nice. Now the next thing is, see, we'll group everything. Okay, and then so the next thing we'll do is, see, I will create a background. Okay, so what background? I will first take an ellipse. You want perfect ellipse? Create it like this by holding
shift.
Okay, and then we'll just keep it over here. Okay, Alt to shift. Okay, for center scale. And then we'll apply a color to this. So we will apply something like a orange, yellow, orangeish color. Okay, this one is better, but we want it to in the fill, not in the stroke. Okay, so something like this, and then we'll make it elliptical. Okay, so then we will just right click, arrange and send to back like this. Okay, okay, we'll actually center scale, Alt shift. And then you can actually center align this. You can also center align the text. Okay, something like this, right? And then to make it attractive, see, we'll apply a drop shadow to this, and we'll use Alt Shift to center scale. Okay, so how we can apply drop shadow? Select it, and then here we will be having effect, stylize and drop shadow. So see here, we'll change the x offset and we don't want this much opacity also, we'll keep it 40. Okay, so something like this. Okay, right. So then to make it more interesting, so I will be creating one more circle here, or instead what you can do, simply select this, Control C, Control F. So I have created one more, and make it like this. See, we have to use Alt and Shift for center scale. Okay, so we'll turn off the fill, keep a stroke. Okay, and then we'll put something here on the text. We'll use this type on a path tool. So we'll just click here, So default text appears. So we'll just say Amazon, okay? Amazon Trading Services. Okay? So we'll just increase the size. Control Shift greater than. So I think you know this Control Shift greater than. Okay? So then we will use the direct selection tool and we'll move it. Okay, so something like this. Okay.
Test karne mein which is not available.
Okay. So the next thing is, see, I want to break the connection between the text and the this ellipse. So we'll go to object and then we'll click on this expand. Okay, now the connection is broken actually, so the ellipse is gone. But one thing we'll do is, see, I'll actually again take a duplicate here, Control C, Control F. Okay, so I will keep it like this, keep one circle here. Okay, and then I will just take a outline, turn off the fill. See, I am going to create a cut here. Okay, I will create a cut. So how to create a cut? First we'll create one point. So we'll create one point and exactly we'll create one more point here. Okay, so I think we have created points. Check whether we have points or not. Okay, then we'll just click that point, and then here we have a scissor here. Just click on that scissor and we'll do the same thing. Just select that point and click on that scissor. So what will happen? So see this top part we can delete. Oh sorry, this one. Okay, so now we only have this bottom part. Now for in the bottom part, what we'll do is, see, I will take one star. Okay, we'll keep this star over here, make it small. Okay, then we'll take one more duplicate here, keep it exactly parallel to this. Okay, now we'll select both the stars, object, blend, and we'll first select the options, specified steps. We'll keep it 20 here. Okay, and then we'll just go to object and blend and make, and then we'll select this ellipse path, and then we'll just go to the blend and then replace spine. Okay, see here. So we got this. Then we will just give it a pure white color. It will be nice. So white is going to be attractive. Okay, so then what you can do is, we will just in the end, I will just take one more ellipse here, Control C, Control F. So keep it here. Okay. Mouse is a little bit problem. Okay, so then what I'll do is, see here, we'll apply a different gradient to this. So where is the gradient tool? Here. Okay, so we'll apply a bluish gradient. Okay, so something like this. Okay, something like this, light blue and dark blue. Okay, see. Okay, so something like this, and then to make it more attractive, we'll give a white outline. See, okay, can you see that? And we can increase the width, but don't make it too thick actually. Okay, this much is okay, right? Okay, so for this also we'll create one outline. Okay, and last and final is we'll just one last outline will create or background will create. Okay, we can create a pure black color, okay, or dark color. Okay, so something like this, then we'll just keep it behind everything. Okay, see, we have created a 3D logo, and for last thing we will create for this text, we will apply a drop shadow. Okay, stylize, see here, drop shadow. Okay, for these things also we will just expand them. Stylize, drop shadow. Okay, we can keep it 20 if you want, right? See, we have created an attractive 3D logo. Sunita, understood? Sunita?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So, last and final, what we'll do is we'll export this. Okay. So, file, export, export as. So, we'll just export it as a SVG. We'll say Amazon, okay? Amazon Trading Service. Just click OK. Okay? So see, we got a crystal clear output. It's very sharp, it's having sharp edges, okay?
Sir?
Yeah.
Now that logo is not in the center of the base, so no, sir. Now if at all we want to drag everything, everything will go here and there, or it will be in the place only, sir? If you want to drag and keep it in the center.
Everything is in the center only, no? What is not in the center, tell me?
Suppose if it is not in the center of the document, if you want to drag, no, sir.
See, if you want to keep everything, if you want to keep everything in the center of the document, first you have to group everything, everything, okay? And then you have to use this option, align horizontal center, so that everything will come to the center, okay? And then after that you can ungroup. If you want to have separate control over each object, you can ungroup.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay. Right. Okay.
So now we understood this. Okay. So we'll continue with this 3D options. Okay. So we have seen how to apply a 3D extrude option for letter, for a single letter, and also we have seen the 3D option for shape. Now we will apply the 3D option for a path, single path. Okay, so just I will select this pen tool. I will just select this path. Okay, we'll turn off the fill. Just let me create a path like this. Okay, okay. Okay. Effect 3D, 3D classic. Okay. Extrude and bevel. So we'll put zeros here. See, I am applying for this just one path. Okay. So what we'll do, just we'll put the cursor in the center input field and hit up arrow. Okay, actually not this one, this one. Okay, x axis. Wait a minute. So just select it. Okay, just put your cursor on the in the top input field. And use up arrow. See, like this. Okay. We can create a ribbon. Okay. Just simply click OK. Then we will just object, go to object and click on this expand appearance. Okay. So then we will actually ungroup it. See, ungroup it again. Okay, till you get the separate objects, and then what we'll do is, see, we'll give separate colors to this. See, here actually what happened is, just a minute. Just move it, we'll delete this. Okay. Then see, these inside parts are there. First, I will unite them using Pathfinder. Okay. Okay, so we'll just give some colors to this. Okay. We'll not give outlines. We'll give only fill color. Right, and for these things give a separate color. Okay, see here we got a ribbon. Okay, and then we'll do one thing to make it look like a ribbon. We'll first use this, we'll select this add anchor point, then I will just pull it like this. Okay, see here we got a ribbon, and we will also create the other side here. See, so how to create other side? So we'll just duplicate it, and then we'll just transform and reflect. Okay. Adjust it properly. See here we have too many points here. So first we will unite here. So where is this? See, unite. Okay. So now the pieces are all united. Center piece. So if you think there are too many points here, we can actually delete the some of the points here. So what you can do, we can use the delete anchor point here so that it looks neat. Here you have to click on the right spot, if not that this error will keep coming. Able to understand? Something like this. okay. Right. So once we have adjusted it, then we will make it more interesting by applying swatches. So we'll directly go to this Gems and Jewels, and we will apply reddish color. Sorry, bluish color. And for these things. Okay, and for this inside part we can apply this this color, okay, or we can apply green, okay, we can experiment like this, okay, like a silky ribbon. See, we got a nice ribbon, 3D ribbon. And to make it more interesting, we'll select it and we'll group it, and we will flip it. See, now it looks nice. So we can center align this, okay? See. So we can use it like a some kind of advertisement. Like say I will take one star. See, let me make it a big star. Okay, see, something like this. But actually, we don't want it its radius to be too big. We will keep it somewhere 90 here, okay, so something like this. And we want more such circles, okay. And we'll give it a yellowish gradient, okay. You can select this and we'll make it elliptical, okay. We'll keep it behind. Okay. So we can use it like a some kind of banner advertisement. Okay, so we'll do one thing. We'll just create one outline here. And we only want a outline here. Okay, and then we'll make it, we'll bring it to the front, okay? Something like this. See? And we'll say Control C, Control F. We'll create one more outline like this. And then here what we'll do, we'll do something like sunlight, okay, or you can say sunny. We'll just say sunny. We'll use impact here. Okay, impact will be nice. Okay, so then what we'll do, so we can give it a pure white color. Okay, and then we'll give red color as a stroke. Okay, so something like this. Okay, so then we'll do one thing, we'll just say Sunny Enterprises. Okay, keep it here. Okay, give it a pure yellow color, yellow fill, and we'll turn off the stroke. Okay, see here. We have created something interesting here. Okay, and we can also say Sunny Enterprises, or we can say we'll write Enterprises as a very small one. Okay, or we'll say LEDs electricals. Hardware. Okay. Right. So something like this you can try. So we have created one logo. See ya. Understood? Sunita, understood?
Yes, sir.
So here, what is the important thing here? So we have created this ribbon. Right, and final touches, just take one background. The background has to be has to have a very opposite color. So I think it should have something like, let's keep a red color, I think, because that is not there, I think. Yeah. And here what you'll do is, you will give an outline. Let's give it a yellow outline. Let us see how it looks. Okay, see here. For this also we'll try to give yellow outline. Okay, see. Something nice, interesting. Okay, and we can actually give some drop shadow for the as a final attraction. Okay, 20 is enough, right? See, another logo we have created, and this time this is a ribbon, using a ribbon. So then we'll export it again. File, export, export as, see, don't always export as SVG, I'm telling you. Sometimes you may have to export as JPG or PNG. Okay, don't always export SVG, because sometimes SVG colors may not be proper. Okay, you may not get exact the colors or exact text, exact shape.
How to differentiate that, sir? That is why you
export as, export in three different formats.
Okay.
Export as JPG, export as PNG, export as SVG. Find, select the format that looks best without any issues, you have to find a format. Okay, so let me this time let me export it as a PNG. Okay, so I'll just say Sunny. Okay, so we'll just see the option. Where is it? Here. So this opens it in Photoshop, something like this. Okay, and let us save it as SVG. File, export as SVG, and you can also export in PDF. Okay. Okay. So where is it? Oh, here. Okay. It looks very nice. See, sharp edges are there. Okay. So this is very important. You need to get sharp edges. Okay.